Water-soluble binders. The binders that we side groups, a lot of side groups that are polar. For example, PVA, PEG, methylcellulose, and starch. Here we have PVA, polyvinyl alcohol, the side group. Everywhere you have a OH group sticking out into the water. Of course, this one you can expect it to dissolve in water pretty well. And people can add this one for water-soluble system to help glue the particles together, gives you the flexibility. Okay? PVP, the CO group. Okay? If you compare this one and this one, which one has higher water solubility? PVA, right? This one is polar but less polar. Okay. And PAA, this one you can probably imagine really likes water, right? COOH, acid group, side group, this really likes water. Okay. PMAA also likes water, but it got a CH3 group on the other side. PEG and PEI. All these are water soluble binders that people can commonly use. And which one to choose? Well, you choose them, as we will talk about, depending on glass transition temperature, for example. We'll talk about it in a moment. Depending on the viscosity of the system. Depending on at what temperature do I get a clean burn out? Okay. And do I need oxygen for burning out, or I only need inert? I can burn out them in inert atmosphere or in vacuum. Okay. Some of them you have to add oxygen in there, but when you have to add oxygen in there, you cannot process the ceramics in inert atmosphere. Some of them you want to avoid oxidation, you want to be able to burn out cleanly in nitrogen or in vacuum. Okay, cellulose. Some of the cellulose, which the R group that is polar, as we see, this R group has OH in it. This R group has OH. Has this one, these types of cellulose. Cellulose is essentially ester, forms between acid and alcohol. But if the R group, one of the R group is highly polar, these type of cellulose may have a tendency to dissolve in water. Okay. On the other hand, we would have binder, that those organic polymers that are dissolvable in solvents. Okay. You would use them. For example, if I do screen printing, what types of binder should I add? Water soluble or solvent soluble? If I do screen printing, solvent soluble, because if I do screen printing, in order to prevent my paste drying on my screen, I cannot use water as my solvent. I have to use the high boiling point solvents, which quite often terpenyl. And if I use terpenyl, I cannot use the water-soluble polymer. I have to use the solvent-soluble polymers. For example, PVB, polyvinyl butyl, PVF, polyvinyl formal, or PMMA. These types of polymers as my binder for screen printing. Okay, cellulose derivative. Here, similarly, vinyl, oxygen, R, but here the R group, as we listed here, are this R group, as we listed here, are polar or nonpolar. Nonpolar, this group is nonpolar. These types of cellulose, like acicellulose, we can add them into the terpenyl solvent for screen printing. Make sense? Okay. So, binder viscosity. Binder is a polymer. When you dissolve polymer into the solvent, they're going to cause viscosity increase, and the viscosity typically increase with binder molecular weight, which means the larger the binder molecules, the higher the viscosity. It also increases with concentration. Here we have one plot. We have the methylcellulose dissolved probably in water. And as we see, the mean molecular weight, as we increase at the same loading level, 2 weight percent solution of methylcellulose in water, and as we increase what? mole, mean molecular weight for the messy cellulose, what changes dramatically? The so-called apparent viscosity increase dramatically, right? So I can change my system viscosity by changing the molecular weight. But at the same time, for the same molecular weight which we plot here, still we are talking about hydroxycellulose. We are talking about different what? Concentration. For the same molecular weight, by increasing the concentration, the viscosity increase would be dramatic. Okay? So it gives you two knobs. One is by changing the molecular weight. One is by changing the concentration. Sometimes you have to adjust the concentration, but you cannot add too high concentration. Why? Because if you have too much binder in the system, as you dry, your material will contain a lot of polymer, and when you burn out, you have a lot of what? Porosity, and which is catastrophic for densification or for sintering. Make sense? So this gives you different knob. I can change if I want higher more viscosity for my slurry, I can change, add more and more binder. But if I want to limit my porosity, I have to think of something that gives me higher molecular weight or different molecule shape. Make sense? Okay. Additional effects of binders. Plasticity. Binder often enables the plastic deformation of green body. Okay, because it's a polymer, right? Plastic deformation means you apply stress to a body, it changes shape permanently. That's how people can do extrusion. You think, I have a ceramic powder, I extrude from this much, extrude it out. If you ever do noodle, spaghetti, using a spaghetti machine, you extrude out, right? The binder, you have to add it. Of course, the flour already has plasticity in it because it's already a polymer. On the other hand, the ceramic doesn't have the plasticity. It's a polymer, you add it, the binder you add gives that plasticity together with a little bit of solvent. Okay? Flocculation, when people add binder, people can make the particle come together to flocculate, to sediment. Okay? And the thickening or rheological control. We just showed by adjusting the molecular weight or the concentration, we can change the viscosity, which is the other way to call rheology. Or thickening. What does thickening mean? To increase the viscosity dramatically. Like for you, when we do screen printing for fine patterning for electronics industry, when you do screen printing, do you want your line to be run away? No, which means you have to, the viscosity cannot be too low, otherwise it's run everywhere. Make sense? It has viscosity, the surface tension is low, which means it's going to wet very well. And if the viscosity is low, it's going to cover everything. When you print fine line, it becomes a white line. So those conditions, you have to add binder, you have to add so-called thickening agent. Okay? May increase viscosity dramatically. Liquid retention. Sometimes you add a binder to maintain some liquid in your system so that you can maintain this plasticity for a certain time, amount of time. Okay? Binder selection criteria. Burnout characteristic. Very important. At what temperature do you burn out? For example, your material can only handle 500. You probably do not want those binders that burn out cleanly only after 500. You want something that burn out at much lower temperature. And burn out whether it's in air or it can burn out in inert atmosphere. For a lot of application in electronics, we want to fire in nitrogen, believe it or not. And in those cases, you do not have oxygen and you do not want to use a binder that needs oxygen to burn out. Okay, it only temperature in organic residue. Some of the binder, like those contain sodium, when you burn out, will the sodium go? Quite often, no. So they are going to remain as an inorganic ash. And quite often for many applications, we do not want the binder that gives us ashes. Okay, atmosphere, air or inert, we just mentioned. Some of them we need inert atmosphere. We need them to be able to decompose instead of burn or combust. Decompose, which means just by temperature, it will decompose into smaller molecule. Instead of you have to react with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. Volume change, very important. You do not want the binder that explode, too much volume change. Okay, you want them to in a controlled fashion, not suddenly everything become gas. Molecular weight, impact viscosity and others. Glass transition temperature, we'll talk about that later. Glass transition temperature. If the too high a glass transition temperature, which means your ceramic body will be too rigid. The too high glass transition temperature, which means at ambient temperature, at room temperature, the material behave like a glass. The polymer behave like a glass. If your polymer behave like a glass, you do not have plasticity. Too low glass transition temperature, it become too soft. So depending on your application, depending on your need on the plasticity and viscosity. Compatibility with dispersant. Okay, normally binder should not displace dispersion so that this suspension become flocculent. Binder molecule should have less polar, should be less polar than dispersion. Okay. Solubility in solvent. Some are water soluble, some are solvent soluble.